Hi, and welcome to Kodi4U. In today's episode, I will guide you through installing the complete TVAddons.AG setup using the configuration wizard for XBMC Kodi. Please note that the official statement on the TVAddons.AG website recommends users to use XBMC Gotham for the time being. However, I have personally experienced only a few minor issues running their add-ons on Kodi. Main issues are some plugin streams not working properly, rare display problems, and in some rare cases, XBMC crashes. The official website moved from xbmchub.com to TVAddons.AG in lieu of the recent name change from XBMC to Kodi. Please note that neither XBMCHub nor TVAddons.AG is a product of Team XBMC and features access to content which may be considered illegal in some countries or states. XBMCHub was established in 2012 as a means to make installation of streaming add-ons for XBMC as simple as possible. What started out as a simple repository has now become a large collection of frequently used video streaming add-ons and tools that can quickly transform your Kodi installation into a massive media repository. By now, TVAddons.AG contains some of the most popular streaming add-ons such as Sports Devil, PrimeWire or One Channel, Genesis, NaviX, iFilms, and much, much more. This video will guide you through installing all the most popular add-ons. However, you can also install only those repositories and add-ons that you would like. Please have a look at my other video for instructions on installing only the FusionSource and XBMC Hub repository. Please have a look at the description for information on where to obtain support for XBMC Hub and the included add-ons. Okay, so as you can see, this is a clean install of Kodi 14.0 and I'm on the most recent nightly build. I'm using a MacBook Pro running OS X Yosemite for this demonstration, however the steps should be fairly similar on all other platforms. So first you will want to go to System and then File Manager. Next, you will choose Add Source and then you will click on the None field. This will bring up a text box where you will want to install, where you want to type http://fusion.xbmchub.com, including the http://. The trail slash is not important for most sources. Click Done and click on the box to enter the title for this source. This can be anything you want. I like to use .fusion. Click on OK and then you've added your source already. Next, we will go through installing the configuration wizard add-on. To do this, you will have to go back to the home screen and this time click on System followed by Settings. Next, click on Add-ons in the bottom left. If you've not installed anything yet, click OK first. Now, here you can do installation of new add-ons by clicking the Install from Zip file, or you can go to Get Add-ons. We go to Install from Zip file, click on the new source that we've just added, which is .fusion, and there it will instruct you to begin by start here if you're new to Kodi. Over there you have various different options. For our case, we're going to run the Hub Wizard to auto set up Kodi. So click on plugin.video Hub Wizard, then wait for a short while and the Hub Wizard will be installed. This is a quick installation wizard for you to install all the most frequently used add-ons for XBMC Kodi. So after a short while, you will see that the config wizard has been installed completely. You will see that in the notification in the bottom right. So after that, you can go to Enabled Add-ons and then Program Add-ons. You can also go to Program and then Add-ons in the main menu. So click on that and then click on Launch. And then you will see that you can install this configuration wizard for various different platforms, such as Mac, Windows, Fire TV, Apple TV, etc. Since I'm running on a Mac OS X machine, I will click on Mac, and then I will click on Yes to customize my add-on selection. So this will download some of the most frequently used add-ons as well as some configuration scripts for your platform. You will have to choose your system that you are running to install XBMC on to ensure that it will download the correct plugins, scripts, and settings files. So wait for a short while for the configuration wizard to be downloaded and then extracted. And once this is completed, there's really nothing more to it. You will see that now on the background changes quickly. And you have all your frequently used add-ons automatically installed. So under videos, we have One Channel, Project 3TV, Ice Films, Genesis, Sports Devil. Then there's also some additional add-ons available over there. Under the add-ons button, such as peer-to-peer streams, etc., solomovie.so, and there's also the XBMC karaoke add-on. Now, the only two plugins that I've had issues with were the XBMC Karaoke add-on as well as the solarmovie.so. So please tread carefully over in those plugins. So under music, you also have several add-ons like, such as radio, Apple iTunes podcast, Broadcastify, etc. And under the add-ons button, there's a couple of more options. Under programs, you will have a few different add-ons installed as well, such as the NaviX, the Addon Installer, as well as the maintenance tool. The Addon Installer and the maintenance tool are some of the scripts that they have installed. So if you go to the Addon Installer, here you can make some minor changes, such as the installer settings. You can install new add-ons. You can go to featured add-ons over there to see all the add-ons that come pre-installed with the installation of this configuration wizard. You can also install additional video add-ons by clicking the video add-ons button. These will only show you the video add-ons that come from XBMC Hub or TVAddons.AG. Okay, so we're not going to be doing that. I do want to take show you quickly the installer settings where you can make some minor changes to what are the various options that are available. Okay, so we go back to the home screen. There we also have the maintenance tool. The maintenance tool allows you to make some quick changes to your settings for this add-on as well. Here you can see some how-to videos. You can do some general maintenance, some system tweaks for specific systems. You can even see your own IP address under what is my IP. But that's basically it. There's all the settings for you to make changes if you would like to. Okay, so that is it for this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please click the like button. Also, hit the subscribe button to subscribe to this channel. Leave a comment on those plugins that you may have issues with. And in any case, thank you for watching and see you next time.